another important topic that can be asked from the GI tract, gastrointestinal septum. Remember, hiatus hernia, very commonly asked. Draw the diagram, there's an esophagus, there's a stomach, and the stomach comes up into the thoracic cavity. There are two types, remember, it can be sliding as well as it can be rolling. And remember, to have clinical features, we require a surgical approach. You give incision, you pull, and then you fix. Corrosive structure of the esophagus. Somebody swallows the corrosives. That can lead to stricture in the esophagus, and it requires a total esophagectomy need to be performed. In the GI tract surgeries, they may also ask about carcinoma of the esophagus, the most common cancer again. Remember to draw, we have two types. Middle third and lower third. Upper third is least common. And there are different causes for middle third and the lower third. We have GERD, Barrett's esophagus, most common cause for lower third. Alcohol, tobacco, all the other causes are in the middle third. Don't forget to write about the initial stages, then spread, and then TNM staging. Then we have clinical picture dysphagia. Diagnosis is done by an esophagoscopy and a biopsy. Confirm the diagnosis. Depending upon the stage, we also remove the esophagus. Esophagectomy, that is what becomes answer for the carcinoma of the esophagus. Dysphagia, differential diagnosis, remember to write about an esophageal causes, pharyngeal causes, and oral causes. Because we have three phases in the deglutition. So we have three main causes for dysphagia. It's nicely given in any of the book. You can, because this is also asked in the practicals very commonly. Differential diagnosis of dysphagia. Esophageal atresia is a congenital condition in which esophagus is an absent and you require to feed the baby from the gastrostomy, or may also go for parenteral feedings. Pyloric stenosis, congenital hypertrophic pyloric stenosis, very commonly asked. Remember, there is a condition in which the pylorus is stenosed. So baby, when the baby has milk, baby has got projectile vomiting. So you usually patient presents in first 2 months of life. Failure to thrive. Weight is not increasing. The patient has got persistent vomiting. Usually a projectile vomiting. During feed, it requires an esophagogastroduodenoscopy to diagnose, treated by pylorotomy surgery. Duodenal ulcer, very commonly asked in the medicine as well as surgery. Remember to write the similar thing, but for surgical approaches, we require only when the ulcer is getting perforated. Otherwise, we have a medical approach. Perforated peptic ulcer. Can you say that? This is what is a surgical case. Perforated peptic ulcer. Now, in this condition, a known case of peptic ulcer present with an increase in the guarding and rigidity in the abdomen, and that can lead to further septicemia, and the patient may also die. Diagnosed with the help of a gas under diaphragm x-ray standing of the abdomen. See a stomach, similar to see esophagus, we can write. Endoscopy in surgery, very common practical question. We have esophagoscopy, gastroscopy, duodenoscopy. We also have colonoscopy. And we also have a capsule endoscopy. Those are the types of surgeries we want to have, or endoscopies we can have in the surgeries. Amoebic liver abscess, remember, because we also need to surgically drain a solitary big abscess like cavity in the right lobe of the liver. Patient usually is a known case of a chronic amoebiasis in which patient has got problems. Presents in the right hepatic pain, ultrasound confirms the diagnosis, and we can go for a surgical drainage of the abscess. Similarly, we have a hydrated cyst in the liver. We also have colysis because of the echinococcus granulosis. Portal hypertension, as we discussed in the medicine, it can be producing ascites, portal vein obstruction, or portal vein hypertension producing esophageal varices as well as rectal varices. Acute cholecystitis, the gallstone is the most common cause. Remember calculus and acalculus, Murphy's triad, and Murphy's sign is also there. And we also go for medical treatment, and then we can go for cholecystectomy. Gallstones, three types: bilirubin gallstones, pigment gallstones, and cholesterol gallstones. Obstructive jaundice is because of gallstones is going to obstruct the biliary pathway, can produce increase in the conjugated bilirubin. Acute pancreatitis is usually a medical condition. Most common cause is chronic acute alcoholism, and patient presents with an acute abdominal pain. Can also be increase in the serum amylase levels. As a life-threatening condition, need to be treated urgently. In viva or in theory, they may also ask about differential diagnosis of splenectomy, or I can say indications of splenectomy. Massive splenomegaly, chronic malarias, hemolytic diseases, thalassemias, sickle cell anemias, in which we can go for splenectomy. In the complication of the typhoid ulcer, we also have typhoid perforation. Very rarely, about 0.1% of the cases, they can perforate because the ulcers are superficial, but they may also go deep. Can produce similar features of perforated duodenal or gastric ulcers. Ileocecal tuberculosis, another intestinal tuberculosis, a bovine type of bacteria, can produce intestinal tuberculosis. Carcinoma of the colon, fairly common in the developed countries because of lack of fibers in the food. There's also right side of the growth, left side of the growth, remember that. Yes, carcinoma of colon. Acute intestinal obstruction, I mean, a very common case that can be kept in the vivas. Or maybe can also be an LAQ that can be asked. Nobody's going to keep obstruction case because those are the hot cases. They usually keep the cold cases. Patient presents with distension of the abdomen, vomiting, as well as dehydration, shock-like state. We're going to discuss about the causes, like for example, acute intussusception, also called telescoping of the intestines. That can be the common cause. Paralytic ileus is also paralysis of the intestine. Lump in the right iliac fossa, then trying to give an appendicular mass. There's an appendicular mass. A chronic appendicitis can develop into appendicular mass. Acute appendicitis, remember there's a McBurney's triad, McBurney's point, McBurney's incision, steps of appendicectomy you should know. Prolapse of the rectum requires a surgical correction. Imperforated anus is a congenital condition, the anus is not getting formed. Patient usually presents with distension of the abdomen because patient is not able to pass the meconium. Requires surgical correction. Internal piles is also a condition in which there is an dilated hemorrhoidal veins. Ischiorectal abscess, very common because of the infected rectal glands. Can spread the infection into ischiorectal abscess. Fistula in ano, again fistula, when we could do fistulectomy, there is a tract that is getting developed and that can produce problem. Inguinal hernia, femoral hernia, very, very, very commonly asked. Don't forget to remember about the surgeries of the inguinal hernia, hernioraphy, hernioplasty, herniotomy. And remember to write about the direct inguinal hernia, indirect inguinal hernia. Remember to discuss about there are mechanisms of prevention of an hernia. Shutter mechanism and all those things. Inguinal hernia, you should know everything about. Similarly, femoral hernia is also there. Burst abdomen is a condition in which you have operated patient on surgery, but the patient has got given away all the sutures and the whole abdomen is open post-operatively. Acute abdomen is a condition in which there's an acute pain in the abdomen. Remember the differential diagnosis depending upon the quadrant in the abdomen. Reflux esophagitis, achilles, is in condition called as GERD. Medical condition. But chronic exposure of an acid, the lower segment, low part of the esophagus becomes Barrett's esophagus. A changed epithelium called as Barrett's esophagus. Achillesia cardia is a condition in which patient is not able to swallow because of the cardiac sphincter is very narrow. Achillesia cardia is also because of the Chagas disease, Trypanosoma cruzi. Esophageal varices is a complication of portal hypertension. We require a sclerotherapy. Or can also have sometimes esophageal perforation because of the foreign body or maybe instrumentation. The rigid esophagoscope can perforate. POF, tracheoesophageal fistula, one of the very common ENT congenital anomaly, which leads to difficulty in having food because of food particle can go into the trachea. Patient can go into gasping because of it. Pyloric stenosis, congenital hepatic pyloric stenosis, Ramstad surgery is a GI surgery performed, vagotomy performed for peptic ulcers. Tumor vagus nerve increases the acid production. If you do vagotomy, cut the vagus nerve, acid production will going to reduce. Melina is in blood in the stool, remember the differential diagnosis we mentioned. Gastrostomy, ostomy is, that means creating an opening. Ostomy is creating an opening. Gastrostomy is opening of the abdomen. Usually required for CA esophagus, patient has got severe dysphagia, not able to swallow, etc. Endoscopy we talked about, colonoscopy we talked about, Cassonis test, the test for the GI infections, liver function test, like bilirubin level, enzyme levels, and SGOT, SGPT, transaminase, alkaline phosphatase, serum albumin, coagulation factors, prothrombin time. Portosystemic anastomosis is required for correction of portal hypertension. Then we also have hepatic angiography may require for the hepatic and the tumor, vascular tumor. Galson complication we discussed, St. Tride we discussed, Murphy's sign we discussed, calotte triangle is for the surgery on the gallbladder. Remember, it can also be asked as an Viva question or it can also be asked in the MCQs. Charcot side, Courbet's law is all asked in the MCQs. ERCP stands for endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography. It's an endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography. It's required to do the gallstones as well as CBD stones. Colloidal cyst is a cyst in the duct of the gallbladder. Annular pancreas, in which pancreas is normally only on the in the loop of the duodenum. But here, pancreas is also posterior to the duodenum, called as an annular pancreas. Sometimes it can lead to obstruction and can create problems. Pseudocyst of the pancreas, in which the pancreatic duct is getting blocked and the secretion which are collected produces a cyst. Splenomegaly, we talked about splenic rupture, we talked about megacolon is because of an absent ganglionic cell layer. Then congenital absence of ganglionic cell layer in the colon. Colostomy is a surgery performed to open the colon directly outside the skin required for the bowel cancers. Ileostomy similarly. Pute Jagger syndrome is a pigmentation on the skin as well as GI congenital anomalies. We talked about this Murphy's tribe, we talked about the appendicular lump, we talked about rectal exam, proctoscopy is a surgery performed, or I can say visualization of the rectum and anal canal with the help of a proctoscope, required for piles as well as the rectal problems. Pilonidal sign is very commonly asked at the short note. This is the those who are constantly or long-term sitting at one particular place, especially the truck drivers and all. The sacral, the skin over the sacrum has got a sinus getting developed. It requires a surgical correction. Even hernia we talked about, hernia, incisional hernia, all hernias we talked about. So those are the